day, everybody. I've been getting a lot of requests to do an update video on my aquarium. Well, here it is. Not much has changed since the last video. This aquarium has been going strong for years. And it only has 3 fish. You don't really see them at the moment. But I've had the same 3 Cory catfish for years. It seems as though they really thrive in this aquarium. Maybe that's because they're the only 3 fish. So they really don't have any stress, you know, created by other fish. So everything belongs to the 3 amigos, the 3 catfish. And these fish are now really not sure if 6 or 7 years old, maybe. Yeah, there's one there. Now, I don't have individual names for the fish. I think one is male and 2 are female, but I'm not positive. But they're really healthy. And, you know, a lot of people, when it comes to tropical fish, and that's what this tank is, it's a freshwater tropical fish tank. You know, it can be kind of hit or miss when it comes to fish. Because I think most of them, you know, pass away pretty quick after a few months. Or maybe even less. But these 3 guys are going strong after many years. Now, underneath this door is where I can gain access to the filter system. This particular tank has a unique filter system. It's multiple stages. And I'm not going to go into it too much, but basically there's a filter with floss and carbon, and then there's another flossy filter, and underneath that there's a chamber with some plastic bio balls in it. And then lastly, it comes up through a sponge filter before the water is put back into the tank chamber. So that's like, say, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's like 5 stages of filtering. And I know it doesn't look very clean, but it actually works really well. Because I mentioned the bio balls. If you don't know what those are, they're plastic balls. About an inch and a quarter in diameter. And they provide some pretty powerful biological filtration. Because in a fish tank, you need good bacteria in the tank. Because the good bacteria converts ammonia, which is the waste from the fish. It converts the ammonia into nitrite. And then the good bacteria converts nitrite into nitrate. And that's part of the nitrogen cycle. That's what they call it. Well, the good bacteria that does all of this work needs a home inside your aquarium to live. And the bio balls, well, I'll flash a picture up on the screen of what they look like, but they're plastic, and you know, they're not smooth. They have all these cutouts and stuff in them so that there's more surface area for the bacteria to cling to. So the open structure of the ball isn't, you know, just to be eye-catching. It serves a purpose. So that design provides as much surface area for the bacteria to live on as possible. Now the shrimp pellets. I usually drop a couple of those into the fish tank every day or two. And they seem to really like them. And you can see that pellet next to that fish's head. Now, I used to have live plants in the tank, but these days they're all artificial. The substrate is black sand and gravel. But it's the rounded gravel. The edges are not sharp. The rounded edge gravel is easier on the barbs of the whiskers of the catfish. I do like watching the fish. You know, I guess most of us know that owning a pet has a measurable benefits to your own health. But you know, those are usually associated with, you know, traditional pets like dogs and cats. But you know, there's a reason why, you know, doctors' offices and health clinics all over the world have fish tanks in them. And if you've got a home aquarium, you can you can get the same benefits right there in your home. But mainly it has to do with stress, because you know, these times that we live in, they are very stressful, especially the last couple of years with the, you know, everything that's going on. But it's difficult to feel stressed when looking at a clean, thriving home aquarium. There's just something peaceful about it that calms you. And that's probably the main reason why you can find fish tanks in high-stress environments like offices, doctor's offices, clinics, hospitals. Because managing your stress level is very important to your overall health and well-being. So something about gazing through the glass into the world that the fish live in is very calming. The stress just kind of melts away. And a fish tank can lead to maybe better sleep, because you know, you need a good night's sleep. Gives your brain, you know, good night's sleep gives your brain time to consolidate memory and build new connections, and you know. But, you know, for many people, sleep doesn't come easy. So watching your fish tank before bed can help calm your body and your mind, maybe enough to where you can fall asleep easier. And if you've got the fish tank in the same room that you sleep in, well, just the noise from the tank is, you know, it's a white noise. It can help you sleep also. So, the rest of these clips were taken a few months earlier. The ones you just saw were taken just the other day. So if you have a fish tank, you can feel less stress. You can get better sleep. And you see, a fish tank, believe it or not, can even improve your heart health. Because looking at a fish tank can slow your heart rate. It can lower your blood pressure. There was a study someone did, don't ask me who, I don't know, but I do remember that just looking at an empty tank was able to reduce heart rate by 3%. And looking at a fish tank that had fish in it, it was able to reduce people's heart rates by 7%. So if you struggle with high blood pressure, or maybe some other heart health issue, having a fish tank in your home might help you a lot. Because watching these guys it's almost hypnotic. So not only does it, you know, make the stress melt away and make your heart rate slow down and your blood pressure to normalize, you know, just the fact that the stress just slips away is great, though. Having an aquarium can even reduce anxiety. I read once where someone did a study that a lot of dental offices will have an aquarium because it was shown that an aquarium in the waiting room somehow decreased the pain felt during the dental procedures. So that's pretty awesome. I think an aquarium can also improve your focus. It can improve your creativity. Because, you know, stress and anxiety from your work can be lowered if you have a fish tank in the office. Because if it's in your workspace, you can kind of zone out, look at that fish tank, I'm trying to figure out how to say what I'm trying to say. It'll give your mind something else to focus on for a few minutes while you work through some other issue with work. So I've thoroughly enjoyed this aquarium. You have to maintain them, which isn't too hard if you have, you know, the habit of doing it. You want to feed the fish, you know, on a regular schedule, not feed them too much. Do some water changes, and check the water. And I have a video on my channel of checking the water, checking the ammonia and the nitrite and the nitrates and stuff. I'll put a link to that video in the description. Maybe I'll put a link to all my aquarium video playlist in the description. These little catfish, they like these little pellets too. So if you're thinking about getting a fish tank, put it somewhere in your house where it's not in the sun. You don't want it to be in direct sunlight or the algae will grow. I don't have any problem with algae because it's not in direct sunlight. I don't know how long these little guys are going to live. Quite honestly, I'm surprised that they've lasted all these years. But I think this type of fish can live 10 or more years. I'm not sure what the key to the success of these fish. I'm not sure what the key is, but I think it's cleanliness of the tank, and that I think is due to the biological filtration, you know, the bacteria that is good bacteria. I think it's also due to the fact that there's not other fish in this tank except for these guys. You know, some fish can be bullies. And they can cause a lot of stress for the other fish. So that's absent from this tank. But anyway, I hope this video satisfies your curiosity about my fish tank and how it's, you know, how it's doing these days. Like I said, nothing really's changed. Same fish, same little guys. Had them for years. So, hope you enjoyed this video, and thanks for watching.